August 4th, 1914, a family sat round the table reading the newspaper.
How could this happen? What will come of us?
Try not to worry, Mary. It's in me over you, see.
Britain was at war, a war that would last for 4.5 years, leaving 17 million people dead.
Millions of boys and men who left to defend their country, hoping for a victory that they would not see.
I wish you weren't going. Take care of yourself, my precious boy.
I love you, son.
This is the scene. Across nations, families united in the wings of God.
Nothing of this year had been seen before, and no one knew how it would end.
Because of the impact it had on people across the whole world. World War I has been thought to be sparked by the assassination of Archduke Franz Ferdinand, heir to the Austro-Hungarian Empire by a Serbian nationalist. Within a month, Austria declared war on Serbia. The first Red War would unleash devastation across the world.
During the four-year conflict, Germany, Austria, Hungary, Bulgaria and the Ottoman Empire, known as the Central Powers, fought against Great Britain, France, Russia, Italy, Romania, Canada, Japan and the United States, the Allied powers.
It's been months, months with no word. Where is my boy?
I know, my love, but we must have faith that he will return.
This was the story in millions of homes. Wives waiting for their news of their husbands, parents waiting for their news of their children, until those dreaded telegrams are not sent.
Thank you.
Fighting in World War One was predicted to come quite well.
Although weapons were available, they were basic and required soldiers to be close together.
Most of the fighting took place. It was known as trench warfare. The Battle of Verdun and the First Battle of Somme are among the deadliest in the history of human conflict. Soldiers wrote to their loved ones regularly. Some even sent poppies from the battlefield to press them in their letters. In Flanders Fields was written by Major John McCrae, who was a military doctor and an artillery commander.
Thank you. One cenotaph means empty tomb.
The cenotaph was very close to be a permanent structure.
It was originally built from wood and plaster for a parade in 1919 to celebrate the signing of the peace treaty.
It was so popular that the current cenotaph we know today was built as a permanent memorial in 1920.
The 11th hour!
sacrifice or service, we would be living very different lives.
Without the sacrifice and service, many more would die.
Without the sacrifice and service, it would be a more dangerous place.
Appreciate their time for bravery.
May we always ride in respect and protect our